Hello everyone, Emmanuel here. In today's video, we're going to see how to update the Substance Painter geometry when using the live link. This has been a highly requested feature and is finally here, so let's get started. Remember, if you like our videos, you can support the content via Patreon or by buying some of our plugins in Gumroad. The links are in the description. So in order to use it, you will need Adobe Substance 3D Painter 7.3 or greater. You can check the version you are using in Help about Substance Painter. The update mesh feature is available with all the compatible DCCs, like Maya, Blender, Cinema 4D, etc. And to control its behavior, you need to go to the Config tab of the plugin, in the General section. If the Close Current Geometry option is checked, every time you send a new geometry, the current Painter project will be closed and a new project will be created with the same mesh you sent. If it's unchecked or disabled, then if you have Painter 7.3 or greater, the mesh will be replaced with anything that you have selected and sent from your 3D app. Otherwise, if you are using version 7.2 or lower and the close option is unchecked, nothing will happen and a message will appear in the Painter's log. The other option is to preserve strokes, which will work as the option when you import the mesh manually, in Edit, Break Configuration. Now let's see the update mesh in action. We start by opening the 3D app. In this case, let's open Blender and Painter, and I'll begin by sending a basic cube and assigning a simple material to the layer stack. In this case, a wood material. Now let's replace the cube with a sphere. So we click Send, and the cube is replaced with a sphere, while the wood material in the layer stack remains. And as you can see, the update is pretty fast. We can do this multiple times. We can even replace the geometry with something completely different. Let's try now to send this monkey head. And as you can see, even if the other geometry still exists in Blender, if it's not selected, it's not sent. Let's select now the cube and the monkey head and send again. And now the Painter project is updated to have both mesh objects. The only thing you need to keep consistent is the material assignment. Otherwise, you will get wrong texture set assignments or ghost texture sets. You can also gradually add new texture sets by assigning different materials. For example, let's give the sphere a new material and send it again. And now we have two different texture sets in Painter. And in the original, we still have the initial wood layer stack. This can be extremely powerful, because now you can adjust UVs in the middle of a texturing process if something is not working as expected, and just send the mesh again and fix it. Or you can improve your workflow by starting the texturing phase earlier, instead of needing to wait till you finish all the modeling. Well, that's all for now. Hope you find this new free update useful, and remember to like and subscribe. See you next time.